the storyline is that he was fired after the year at Buffy by the council. And so he goes on a soul-searching journey across America, kind of reinventing himself as a independent demon hunter dedicated to doing good in the world. And when he arrives on in the first episode of Angel, it's because Wesley is tailing the same demon that Angel is tailing, and they bump into each other.
Wesley, I'll wager you never thought you'd see me again.
Tell you the truth, I hadn't given it much thought one way or the other.
I'm the one asking questions here, and I think it only fair to warn you. Any sudden movement, and I'll be forced to...
Right? You had a question?
The character in the early days when we were forming Angel Investigations complimented Angel and Cordelia very well because he was much lighter and kind of silly, and it brought a different element to the show.
Wesley, what are you talking about?
Well, earlier when he came to pick up the baby, Connor started crying and Wes hummed a little lullaby and I read him and... I don't know why he did it.
Did what?
He's been to see Holt behind your back twice. And he's not taking the baby overnight. He's taking the baby away. For good.
Wesley is particularly concerned about the ramifications of what this means, the child of a vampire, and in his research finds some very frightening material concerning Connor. And that sets up what's really a very large arc for the end of that season, the beginning of season 4, which is to do with how Wesley handles that information and his decision to take the baby away and the rift that occurs within the group because of that decision, and then the things that happen to Connor as a result of the kidnap.
I will take good care of him as though he were my own son. He'll never even know you existed.
Well, he was taken from one of my enemies, Holtz, back in the 70s.
We have encountered the big bad this year as a tremendous beast from the core of the earth, and we've been struggling with him for a couple of episodes.